SOARS is an instrument that reproduces the biology, the chemistry, and the oceanography of the wind-driven sea. SOARS stands for the Scripps Ocean Atmosphere Research Simulator. It's an instrument funded by the National Science Foundation, supported by UC San Diego. We've always known that the air-sea boundary is important. What we didn't understand was how the combination of biology and chemistry and wind and waves were all working together to create this unique and special place that impacts weather and climate. How are we going to understand this complex, connected system so that we can predict what future climate's going to look like and what future weather's going to look like?
So one of the things that's different about this is it's got, you know, it's huge for one, but it has an enclosed air where everything is clean. And so the gases that come out, everything that comes out into this clean atmosphere. So we can actually study what directly comes out of the ocean. And so now we're taking the next step and being able to simulate many more oceans, different temperatures. We can basically make all these different conditions to look at how processes in the ocean are affecting our atmosphere and our climate and human health.
We operate SOARS by introducing seawater that we're able to pump in directly from the ocean. A paddle pushes that water along in a 120-foot long channel, producing waves up to 3 feet in height. A water temperature handler in the wave channel can heat or cool the seawater anywhere within a range between 33.8 degrees and 86 degrees Fahrenheit. Because the composition of the air is vitally important in creating a controlled environment, we installed an air filter capable of removing all ambient particles, 1/1000th of an inch from the air we draw in from outside the simulator. We provide the same light that organisms in the ocean would experience through the use of 6 solar tubes positioned just above the channel. A wind turbine can take the air that we purified earlier and blow it through the channel. We can reach wind speeds up to 63 miles an hour, near hurricane force. Finally, just as we can manipulate the temperature of the water, we can also control air temperature. An air temperature handler can produce temperatures ranging from 86 degrees Fahrenheit to negative 7 degrees.
SOARS has 4 operation modes. There's the wind wave mode, where we make waves and blow wind. The aerosol mode, where we study tiny little droplets that come out of the wind-driven ocean, go into the atmosphere and form clouds and ice. We have the ecology mode, where we study the organisms that live near the surface of the ocean, and polar mode, where we can cool the water down to freezing temperatures and make sea ice.
One of the things that's very important about SOARS is that it brings all the capabilities of our older instrumentation into the future, as well as provides a whole bunch of new capabilities that we couldn't even dream of a few decades ago. The ability to control the temperature, to control gas concentrations, all these things let us simulate not just what's happening around us now, but what's going to be happening on the Earth and into the ocean in the future.